Welcome back to Sun Innovative YouTube channel. We are back with a new video on analog to digital converter ADC to improve the closed loop system design. So let's start this video. As we know, nowadays closed loop system using the PI controller or the hysteresis controller is become more popular to operate machine automatically and the efficient way. Hence, it is become also important to design a feedback loop very precise and accurate as much as possible. So this video is specially created to know how ADC will help us to design the closed loop system in digital controllers. So I will take one example in MATLAB simulation, and it will help us to select the best control technique. So before that, we need to understand that how the ADC got worked. So here it is. ADC is used to convert the analog to digital signals, and it is done in a three different segment, which is sampling, quantification and decoding, and it is a sequential process. So here is a conversion process of ADC. First is sampling, and the another two in the first process, the signals is divided into the sampling time segments, which is shown in diagram, and it's depend on the speed of converter, which are made up of the op-amps, digital clocks, integrated ICs, etc. So then the second process is decide possible steps according to the bias voltage delta V, and it's called resolution of output signals. In a simple analog signals will be cutting into the many division according to the voltage steps and sampling time. Now at the last, both the segments are goes to the store somewhere in memory of the semiconductor devices like ADC register, and that can be used to process further in a controller of programming. Now it's time to improve the ADC performance, and it's possible by the two methods, that is a sampling rate and resolution. So let's see how the both parameters are used to get accurate the output voltage of ADC. So here is a 2-bit ADC and its output signal, and the another, that is a 4-bit output and waveforms, and the last 8-bit and its waveform. So you can compare, that is all bit operation with the output that is increasing in bit values. So signal does become more accurate and near to the ideal values. So this is happened when we increase the value of sampling time and the delta V. Okay, now this is the types of ADC here: flash type, sigma delta type, multi-slope type, and the SAR, successive approximation. Okay, let's see working of the flash ADC and the circuit source in a diagram made up of the comparator and the op-amp, and will gives you the two state at the output when the both signals got compared. So here is a few lines about the method, in which one method is very fast because many op-amps are used to do the parallel operation, and the increasing in comparator will become a more faster output voltage. But the many disadvantages like increasing in additional component will become a more expensive and the power consumptive item. So it's having the low resolution and bad quality. So let's move to the next one, that is a sigma delta method, in which one integrator is used to remove the capacitor was used in a previous method of the flash ADC. So this integrator is act as a combined signal processor, and will compare by the closed loop system of DAC, digital to analog converter, and it is will rotate the values until it gets satisfactory resolution at the output. So this method is faster, good resolution, and the operates in a closed loop system. So the issue is associated with this method, it is oversampling, because in this fast operation time, sometimes the values are overwrite in the output voltage. So the previous value stored in a system that will be going to overwrite it. Now move to the next method, which is dual slope ADC. This is unique method to perform ADC. Here is the capacitor is used to control the slope of output signal across the ideal signals. Here capacitor is used to noise removing is also good, and the resolution is also good. So extra component is required to achieve the good accuracy and the slow operation due to the charging and discharging states of the capacitor. Now the last one, that is a SAR, successive approximation ADC, the popular one and the faster one. It's quite similar to sigma delta method because it's used the closed loop system also. Only the one thing is changes here, the output is become parallel, and the after the comparison it gives the different type of output voltage in a parallel. according to the number of bits are given to the system. Hence, this system is become more faster than the sigma delta, and the method having the advantage like faster operation, good resolution, accuracy, low power consumption, and the bad about this speed limitation is clock up to the 6 Mbps, and it depend upon the manufacturer of ADC. So here are the hardware pictures of few ADCs. So it was all about the ADC working and the how to improve the ADC performance. So we have concluded in these techniques that increasing in sampling rate and the resolution will give us more accurate and more precise output voltage. So this methods need to prove somewhere. So let us start the MATLAB simulation to prove this theory. Okay, this is the simulation of analog to digital converter ADC with the different type of ADC of 4 bits, 8-bit and 16-bit. So as you can see, this is the circuit diagram of single phase non-linear load, and this is a single phase here, 50 hertz, and the AC voltage supply, and the voltage is set, let me show you, this is 100 volt peak and the frequency is 50 hertz, and this is non-linear because the full bridge diode bridge rectifier is connected, and the capacitor, and this is the load resistance, and this is the one of technique that is called burden resistor voltage dividing network to get the voltage signals at this resistor. So this is also the one measurement block. So now thing is why we have selected two different methods here, because one is resistor method and one is direct transformer coupling method, so that we need to see the how ADC performed in a different situation like a sudden change in voltage and the different voltage which is generated due to the load and which is short circuited sometime from the source. So let's start this simulation. So here let me show you the all values of this simulation. So this is capacitor, this is resistor, and this is supply, and this is the burden resistor values. So you can see this one, and this is the signals which I have taken from the V1 across this R1 resistor, and the one disturbance I have created at this sample time, and this is initial because I don't want to change anything, and this is final value, and the thing is changed here, the final value is at 2, it means after this time it will be double of the output voltage. So I have just created some disturbance to the output voltage, and the same signal is goes to the three different ADC, that is 4-bit, 8-bit and 16-bit, and these are the go-to signals, and I have taken these signals to compare the output voltage of the different ADC, and these scopes are connected to get the results, and in bottom you can see the 4-bit ADC, 8-bit ADC and 16-bit ADC. So this is also have taken from the source VAC, and the current which is goes to the diode bridge rectifier. So these things is required here because sometimes the engineers do also design the closed loop system of the non-linear loads, like to design the PI controller, hysteresis controller. So that time we need this type of analysis of the ADC. So for that purpose we have compared here the source voltage and the non-linear current, so that we can see that how the non-linear compensated current will affect to design the closed loop system. So now let's start the simulation so we can understand these things. So let me show you how it got run. So I clicked on a run button, so it will take some time, and I will also show you the values of this ADC, don't worry about it. And okay, this simulation is run now. So now first I will open this this scope and will show you that result. So this one is taking some time. So this is the scope you can see, and let me rearrange this. So this is the voltage signals of three different methods. You can see this is 4-bit ADC, this is 8-bit ADC, and this is 16-bit ADC. So as you can see in the sample rate and the division of the voltage, you can easily got compared that how the blocks are moved to the one position to the another position in a different segments. So it is a distorted waveform, and this is compared to good, and this is the very accurate. And let me zoom the result also by taking this zoom option of the MATLAB, so that I can prove very easy steps. See this one, let me do the one zoom in of y-axis. So here it is, you can see. So as you can see in detail, this is a DC values which is constant for this time interval of 0.034 to 0.036. And as you can see in 8-bit ADC, there is a 3 steps are associated with the ADC, and in the last one 16-bit ADC having the exact instantaneous voltage with a step by step, so it got every values of the analog signals, and it doesn't miss any values from the signals and the source. So it is a very good system when you use the 16-bit ADC compared to the 4-bit ADC. And let me show you another examples of this ADC, so you can see the comparison is made here, and here the sudden change is created, so that we can see the how ADC behaves under the sudden change. So my point is, our ADC should also perform the very exact output, because sometimes in closed loop system we have the non-linear and distorted output voltage, so that time our ADC should also perform a very good. So here it is, you can see the each and every instantaneous voltage, and this is the reference, actually the white line, and this is the red line, that is actual ADC. So here you can see this is the missed one, and it is missed one values, and here in this method you can see the each and every instantaneous is got compared, and in 16-bit every instantaneous voltage got compared with the comparator of ADC, and no values are missed in this 16-bit ADC. So this is quite compare good one, and this is the individual performance of the ADC. So let me show you this one also. So let me open this simulation of 4-bit, so you can see the white diagram, that is the input voltage source, and the red is non-linear current. And when the both signals got compared, so this is the error signal, and it is very much distorted, and the steps are very higher, because it takes more time to jump one value to the another value, so it means it is a very bad sample time. And this is the distorted and compared output voltage of ADC. And let me take the 8-bit ADC, and here I take the 4-bit because I want to compare the 8-bit and 4-bit. So see this one example, the reference is very good sampled, because we have taken the 8-bit ADC, and this is the 4-bit ADC in a non-linear current. So whatever the results is came from the ADC, that is you can see this portion is become very good, but inside the portion is remain the same sample time, and to jump one value to another value it takes more time, and the same DC component. So it is a bad effect on a controller to judge that the instantaneous voltage. And the last one, that is a 16-bit ADC. So here you can see the result. So this one you can see the non-linear current and the sinusoidal voltage when they got compared. So accurate and exact output voltage we got from the ADC, because there is a no direct jump to the DC values one position to another position. So in this ADC each and every instantaneous voltage got compared, and the without missing any values from the ADC, so that we can accurately compare the hysteresis or the PI controller using this ADC. So let me show you the final signals to compare the different ADC in the controller. So this is the first one, this is the 4-bit ADC, this is the 8-bit, and this is the 16-bit. So obviously you can see the very accurate and very near to the ideal values, that is a 16-bit ADC. It means the point is, when you increase the beat operation of the ADC, so your controller can sometimes slower to operate, and the sometimes it is not accurate because of the very much process of the values. So my question is, you just select the controller which is having the higher bit operation so that your controller of hysteresis or the PA controller should accurately or the precise compare the instantaneous voltage. And to remove or to the eliminate the harmonics from the system, it would be very easy, or the accurate from the many devices like UPQC, state comb, and the series and shunt active filters. So this is the my point of analog to digital controller, how to select the ADC and the how it behaves under the digital controllers in a DAC system. So this is the my point. So thank you guys, thank you very much.